What's good, guys? We are here with Sabella vs. Googly for Ulti Winners Bracket. This is game 1. This is only a replay for 30 turns. I recorded the rest of the game live. Game 2 and game 3 will be separate videos. It will be completely live. You will have to smoke this chat and everything. Don't worry about that. The other Ulti series are going to be coming. CL vs. Extra Shine and Karen Smith with Black Oblivion. Everything is going to be coming live. Just give me some time. I'm going to pump out the content. So looking at it, Googly has an interesting type of stall team, but most likely Pursuit Tar to potentially help him versus a choice like Tapulia to pursue that. I think it's either Scarf or Band Tar. Obviously Mega Sableye. Interesting that he only has Sableye to keep off Hazards, so if the opponent has a Rocks Clef, Hazards are gonna go up every time. And Pukimoku we see is level 60. It's most likely Innards out and it's level 60, so it dies easily to a specific threat and can get rid of that. I'm not sure if it's specifically for Kartana, because looking at it, Kartana, if it's the SD set that Sabella usually uses, it kind of destroys this team. This is like the Chansey offense. Sabella used this quite a few times, but usually he has a different version with Pinsir over DNC and Clefable over Slowbro. I think this Chansey's T with Rocks, Softball, and Seismic Toss. This is Scarf Excadrill, which is going to be annoying. It's going to be annoying for Sabella if Hazards go up, because he cannot really spin unless he predicts perfectly. Like, if Sabella comes out, it obviously blocks the spin. So this is, it seems like a tough matchup for Sabella unless he can sweep with his Kartana, but like I said, there's the innards out. Pukemoku. So he leads up with Diancie. If this Glisco is not Spadef, he can Twit KO him, but he obviously doesn't want to stay in here, no potential Earthquakes. He just goes into Chansey. If this Glisco has knockoff, it's really annoying for Sabella. I assume he's just gonna get up his rocks here because Googly doesn't have any way to get rid of the rocks. So why not get them up before Sableye Mega evolves? I assume Googly is gonna go for his own rocks. If he has T-Wave for Kartana, that would be really nice for him. So if this is the sub SD Kartana, he can sub up and then SD. There's a Toxapex, and yeah. This is a big threat to Googly. I don't know, like sub is obviously overall a good versus fatter teams because you don't want to get Skull Burned by Pex. But the problem here is this might have brought him into range from Pukemoku the sub. Maybe it didn't even. Maybe if this is max HP, it would have died anyway. But he goes into Ferrothorn here to weaken the Kartana a bit with Iron Barbs. And I'm pretty sure now it's in range from Pukemoku if it wasn't before. So Kartana is either Z Night Slash or Z Sacred Sword. He does go for hard Z move as Googly sacks off the Pukemoku. Black Hole Eclipse obviously kills the Pukemoku from this level 60, dies to everything. Even if it wasn't a Z move from Kartana, it would have died to everything, I assume. But Innards out kills the Kartana, and now Sabella's main way of breaking Googly's team just died. So he's gonna fish for Discharge Para here, I assume. The T-Spikes are super annoying for Sabella, otherwise DNC could put in the work potentially if it has HP Fire, Earth Power, and if the Glisco isn't Spadef, Moonblast is also really nice for that, like I said already. So he's gonna knock off, or Will-O-Wisp probably knock off first, yeah. So Sabella can roost or fish for a Discharge Para here. He roosts first as he's gonna try to wisp this and he misses. So Sabella has the pressure ability, so he's wasting some Will-O-Wisp, some knockoff PP. He's trying to waste some more recover from the Sableye. Sabella is probably gonna go for Protect here because Googly realizes that the Zapdos is staying in. No, he didn't go for Protect, okay. He wants to burn him first. Yeah, that makes sense. He wants to burn him before he wants to start protecting. Now he's gonna recover here though, because if you don't recover here and you get Para, you're in a bad spot. Because like if you don't get Para this turn, but you don't recover and you get Para the next turn, your Sableye would be potentially dead. So now you can, he spams recover. He doesn't want to risk full Paras, understandable. So Sabella is eventually going to switch out. I think he's going to protect eventually. Mm-hmm. So Sabella can. Sabella doesn't have a good switch into this, to be honest, though. Mm-hmm. So he's yeah, okay, he just stays in. Yeah, I just realized he doesn't have a good switch into Sableye at all. Like, he has the DNC, but he doesn't want to get poisoned. He wants to try to rapid spin before, but it's going to get hard to get the spin out. Even if that's a Calm Mind Slowbro, I don't see it winning the game. Nice play by Googly going at T-Tar. This is a pretty free crunch for him. If he's banned, Sabella has no switch-ins. The only switch-in would be the DNC, but the DNC would get poisoned if he goes Chansey. I think that's Scarf damage, not banned, but it's still 2-hit KOs him because of the Sandstorm and the poison damage. So there goes the Chansey. He can now go into Excadrill. And he has to predict if he goes for Earthquake here or if he goes for Spin. He obviously might have to think about Googly potentially going into Sableye on his spin. So he goes for Earthquake. This is a free switch for Googly into Gliscor now. Googly can also stay in and go for Leech Sheet. Predicting Sabella to double potentially. because he knows that Googly knows that he's locked into Earthquake, but he just Earthquakes again. Googly plays it safe, and yeah, Googly can just go for like a knockoff or Earthquake here. Knockoff wouldn't do too much to Zapdos, it lost the item already. He just goes for Earthquake, so Sabella stalls out to Earthquake PP there. I gotta pay attention to the turns because we're gonna be live in like 7 or 8 in 8 turns from here. So Sumi's gonna Roost. Oh, Discharge. Okay, so he's trying to get the para on the Tita. Yeah, that actually made sense because if he Roots there and the Tita comes in, the Zapdos is... like, Sabella's in a bad spot, and so if he gets the para there, he would've potentially been able to deal with the Tita a bit better. But yeah, he knows there's a Scarf Tower, so... if Googly predicts correct here, he can go for Pursuit predicting the switch into Excadrill, because Excadrill might come out predicting a Stone Edge. But to be honest, overall, Googly can just click Crunch, like Googly doesn't lose anything. Yeah, yeah, he can just click Crunch, yeah. There's no reason to go for Edge, yeah, exactly. I don't know, for a second I thought he might go into for Edge, but like there's actually no reason, like because the only switch into Crunch was DNC, and that gets poisoned. Yeah, so never mind there. So he goes into Drill here, let's see if he tries to spin this time. I feel like he's gonna be forced to Earthquake again. If he Earthquakes again, he gets him here, but he spins. Ah, so Googly gets the play correct there, he gets a free recover here with a Sableye. But yeah, Googly, he uses stall a lot, but at least he uses some creative stall, not the same standard thing every time. He gets Parrot there, and Slowbro can potentially Calm Mind up, but the thing is, like I said earlier, it depends on Slowbro's coverage. It probably cannot kill everything, because if it has Scald and Psychic coverage, Pharaoh can kind of wall it, even though it's already low. If it doesn't get burned, it kind of walls it and it can leech shield it. And now he knocked off the lefties and he's poisoned, so he's forced to slack off. If he has like Flamethrower instead of Psychic coverage, he goes into Tita expecting the slack off there. But I was trying to say, oh, nice play by Sabella, fire play. Does he die to Sandstorm? I think he lives Sandstorm, but toxic. What I'm trying to say is if he has like Flamethrower to kill Ferrothorn, that means he probably doesn't have Psychic coverage to hit Toxapex. He can just go for Earthquake here, pretty much get his kill as he switches out to get regen. And what, Drill lived, that's interesting. Well, I assume Sabella's now gonna go for Earthquake. It's pretty obvious that he's gonna go into Sableye to block the Rapid Spin because he wants to keep up the Toxic Spike. Toxic Spike is just really nice for the DNC, because the DNC is always a potential big threat with Earth Power. And yeah, now the DNC got poisoned, and I'm gonna pause it and be right back with the last few turns live narrated. We are back live with the last few turns between Sabella and Googly. So he switched out the DNC, it took Poison Rocks knockoff. I feel like he could have just sacked his Excadrill, but yeah, it didn't make a huge difference. His Drill dies to Rocks. And they're going to DNC means he took a bit more poison damage, because now he's forced to sack his Drill anyway to Scald. I mean, he could also go hard on the Slowbro, but I think he's just gonna sack his Drill here. So, like, he could've just sacked that last turn. But, like, this game is just highly in Googly's favor, and, like, there's not even much to analyze anymore. I think I've pretty much said everything already in the turns where I was looking at the replay. Basically, the deciding point that I've already mentioned is, no matter what Slowbro's coverage is, it's not gonna be able to beat Googly. Even if it has a Psychic Stab for Pex, it's gonna be able to haze that away. And if it doesn't have Psychic Stab, it has Flamethrower for Pharaoh, then it goes completely walled by Pex. They've already talked about this, I'm pretty sure. So he's gonna go for Slack Off here. Googly's gonna go into Ferrothorn and attempt to Leech Seed slash power up this Slowbro. It's already knocked off, so it's gonna be taking a good amount from the poison every turn. There's no lefties to like help him counteract the poison a bit. And yeah, even if he has Flamethrower here, it's not gonna change the outcome of the game. It's just gonna help him to kill the Ferrothorn. The only way I can see him winning is with DNC off-power critting or Moonblast critting, or maybe both. Moonblast creating this Gliscor. Oh, he has Flamethrower, cool. But yeah, like I said, doesn't matter. So it's Scald, Flamethrower, Slack Off. And Calm Mind? Is that already revealed? I don't remember if he revealed Calm Mind. But yeah, if he has Taunt here, Googly, that would be amazing for him. Because Sabella's kind of forced to go for Slack Off here, and even if he Scalds predicting the Taunt, it doesn't help him because he will just take too much damage. The poison and everything. So he's just gonna Slack Off, I assume, yeah. And he seems to not have Taunt. But yeah, poison here is just amazing for the Gliscor here. And Scald is, even if Scald does a good chunk, let's say this is a speedy Gliscor or a Fist Dev Gliscor, and Scald does a good amount, this is still fine for Googly. And he has that poison heal, and the Slowbro is going to be forced to keep slacking off. We do see Scald actually does a good chunk, so it is definitely some sort of fast or Fist Dev Gliscor. But yeah, exactly. Gliscor has Roost, and Slowbro is forced to slack off. And it's like basically, Gliscor heals every time with Toxic heal. Slowbro takes every turn chip from Toxic. At least it's not badly poisoned, at least for Sabella. If you get a crit, that would be nice for him. Basically, Googly stalling out Scald. And once Sabella goes for Calm Mind, then he's forced to go in his Toxapex. And yeah, he already revealed Calm Mind, okay. When he goes into his when he goes for Calm Mind, then he's forcing Toxapex to haze the Slowbro. Oh, he's not even forced to. Toxapex just walls the Slowbro, but haze has so many PP he can just afford to click haze. And yeah, if Sabella wants to win, he probably has to Scald crit the Gliscor here would be helpful, and then maybe off power the crit the packs with the DNC. I don't see how else he can win. I mean, if he crits the Gliscor, then he can stall some PP out of the Toxapex with the Slowbro. But I still think it won't be enough because Haze has like 48 PP and Slowbro is on a timer and Toxapex isn't on a timer, so it's still in Googly's favor. Even if the Toxapex gets burnt, he has Black Sludge to negate counteract. Pretty sure that was already revealed that he has Black Sludge, right? So yeah, Sabella eventually Calm Minds, but he still didn't. Then the Gliscor would be forced out. But yeah, it's pretty obvious that Googly wins this. But I still want to bring you guys the last few minutes live, and so you guys can see some smoke just chat. Like I said, for the game 2, there's gonna be, the entire game is gonna be live, and there's gonna be Estus chat, and potential game 3. If Sabella wins game 2, there's gonna be game 3. If Googly wins game 2, it's gonna be over. There's also, if that happens, it's also gonna be live. And yeah, whatchamacallit. Basically, the reason why this, I think I already said, but yeah, so he commented up, he was forced into packs, and now he hates. He's going back to Gliscor now, okay, he's forced to Slack Off here. He's just gonna Earthquake again. He can obviously not switch into DNC, Poison plus Rocks plus Earthquake would destroy him. But whatchamacallit, I forgot what I want to say. Yeah, I think I've already mentioned this, but this game was like early in the morning, so this is why I missed the beginning from game 1. He's gonna Slack Off again here, as Gliscor is just gonna Earthquake. Oh, he roosts. Okay, he doesn't wanna risk dying to Scald. Actually, yeah, that was the better play on Googly's part. Cause yeah, Slowbro was too healthy, so that was he had to roost there. He made the correct play. So Bella already said GG, but they're still playing. Yeah, he didn't lose anything from roosting. I don't know why I thought he could Earthquake there. That would've been risky a bit. Yeah, so now he's gonna go back to Pex and haze this. It would have been a bit risky, it would have been an unnecessary back play if he didn't roost with the Gliscor. I just messed up there. Yeah, game's still over. I really hope they'll just Sabella just forfeits because, like, there's no point in continuing. Pex is gonna haze this. Slowbro's forced to go for Slack Off here. And then after that, you can try to get the burn on the pecs. But yeah. Like, I really don't know what to narrate anymore because it's just pretty obvious who's gonna win, and I've pretty much said what I had to say. Let's see if Sabella can bounce back in game 2. Hope you guys stay tuned for game 2 and more snake talk. Why can I not talk? More snake talk content, more ulti content, all that good stuff. As okay, of course my this is like the recording that I'm narrating over. Of course the screen was like weird as fuck there for a second. But yeah, he's gonna, okay, finally forfeits, and I'll see you guys with game 2. Peace.